fight, but spite as well, because so much is on the line. How do you handle, you know, sometimes the entourage of Devin Haney, the young Church down there as well, these mind games? Is that just, you just tell JoJo just to stay focused and block that all out?
Yeah, just tell him, just ignore him, man. You know, it's just a bunch of hype and stuff, you know what I mean? I mean, this is MGM boxing. It's not a circus. I mean, that's for the other casino down the street. You know what I mean? But, you know, they do what they do. He's getting paid pretty good money, you know what I mean, to do what he does. But, you know, if he wants to embarrass himself, that's fine. You know what I mean? But, you know, we're going to do what we need to do on Saturday night.
JoJo, massive moment for you on Saturday night. I want to say thank you for taking this opportunity. I know that you raked Devin Haney. I know you were due to fight Ryan Garcia. We goaded you a little. We didn't need to really do that because you step up to challenges. And you accepted this challenge. You sit here now. All the talk, of course. Say it again. MGM Grand, World Lightweight Championship. This is the biggest moment of your career.
Oh, absolutely. And I'm excited for it. I did everything. I paid all my dues. Not even inside this training camp, but just my whole entire career, fighting the best opponents possible to make me ready for this moment. And I'm ready for this moment. I already, you know, paid all my dues inside of the ring. I had a tremendous training camp. We brought in some good sparring partners as well. And we're ready to go out and execute my game plan December 4th.
Obviously, you won the IBF world title against Tevin Farmer, and then you missed weight against Rakimov. But what we've seen since that moment is a much more focused JoJo Diaz. A big win for you against Javier Fortuna at lightweight as well. You seem incredibly focused in your mind right now and in your training.
Oh, absolutely. I already know that this is the moment that I prayed for my whole entire life, and for God to be blessing me with this opportunity, I'm ready for it. I'm not going to cut any corners, and I haven't been cutting any corners, and I'm just built the way that I'm built, and now I'm going to go out there and just execute what I have to do.
An unbelievable fight last weekend, George Kambosos with the upset as well. Expect a tough fight with Devin Haney, a tricky fight. Everybody talks about what you must do in this fight. You must get in on the inside. You must show your dog in this fight as well. But you talked about your own technical ability as well, and you expect a tough fight against Devin Haney.
Yeah, I expect it. I mean, it's going to be a good fight because we're both smart fighters. I'm not just going to be a brawler in there. I'm going to go out there and do what I have to do, adapt, and do what I have to do to come out victorious. I'm going to go out there and, you know, hurt him to the body, hurt him on top, but also I'm going to show my boxing skills as well. I mean, I'm a 2012 Olympian. I fought in there with the best fighters in my divisions in the past with Tevin Farmer, Gary Russell Jr., Andrew Concha, all these guys, and I'm planning on doing the same with Devin Haney.
Obviously a big moment for your career finally as well, but you know, Devin Haney talking about George Kambosos and the Undisputed Championship, but a win for JoJo Diaz puts you in line for that fight, on the verge of just massive career defining legacy, super fights, super money. Everything comes to JoJo Diaz through victory on Saturday.
Oh yeah, absolutely. But my main focus is Devin Haney, just being the shadow of him and taking his will and taking his soul come Saturday night, and that's what I'm planning on doing. That's my main focus right now, is just going out there and just punishing him.